Hey, welcome back, guys. Sorry that these have been coming out so inconsistently. I took like a week off just to do stuff. I'm super busy getting ready for a bunch of stuff going on. But sorry, we're back now. If you don't know, coming up on October 17th, episode 200 of Irrational Passions podcast is happening. So that's gonna be live on twitch.tv/irrational passions. It's easy to remember because it's just like our YouTube thing. Come on, girl. Yeah, it's gonna be fun. We're going to be taking calls on Skype, and having a good time. Alright, goddamn. So, tune into that, October 17th. So it's like, that's pretty close. That's soon. And then the week after that, October 25th, which is a Saturday, is EXTRALIFE. And we'll be playing video games for 24 hours. To raise money for Child's Play Charity. Me and the rest of Team Irrational Passions. So. Check out that. That'll be fun. Oh, goddamn. Really? I figured that out. Because I had to get into this room. Thanks. So yeah, just check those two things out. I think I might, I'll try and put stuff in the description. Because we have, like, an EXTRALIFE page on the website. So you can just check out the details. And I'll post, like, a link to our Twitch. And whatnot. But, now we're playing Zelda. It's Wind Waker. We're not fucking around anymore. They're dicks. You hear me? They're the biggest dicks. So, I like the Earth Temple a lot. I think, like, all the dungeons in this game are pretty excellent. Because there's only, I guess if you include the Forsaken Fortress, there are six. And I don't include Ganon's Tower, because Ganon's Tower is bullshit. Which again, I've complained about on multiple occasions before, but you'll see what I'm talking about. As far as Ganon's Tower being completely true, but it's a little Wind Waker trick. If you remember from my Wind Waker playthrough, or just from Wind Waker in general. When you're fighting the king of Akana Village, the Akana Kingdom, King Akana, I don't know, I forgot what his name is. He does have a name, but I forgot, as I mentioned. He covers up the windows, and you need the sunlight to defeat him. Use the mirror shield. Yes. Thank you, okay. Dunskies. It's weird, like, this temple, reminds me a lot of Majora's Mask. This temple specifically. I don't think the Wind Temple really does. The Wind Temple is okay. It's, like, the weakest dungeon in the game, I think. Honestly. So now I can get up. I can just use the command song. Command whatever. What's it called? The command melody? Oh, it doesn't say. That's right. Because this game is better. I let you see. You see how quick it is. Like, I play it and then I'm in control of medley, right? In the original Wind Waker, it would, like, do the thing where it would play it again. Like, you play the command melody. And it's like, it's, they very much cleaned up Christ. You see how, like, I kept flying through a little bit right there? That was weird. Okay. But yeah, in the original OG Wind Waker.
What are you doing?
Oh, I guess it's too heavy with the thing on. Never mind. I figured it out. OG Wind Waker has the, it's so slow. Like, I think their goal with this version was just to make the game faster. And they totally fucking succeeded. Swift sail and all. I think the swift sail is the biggest thing. But, like, you know, just, like, little subtle things. I'm not using a gamepad, because I chose not to. So you can see me fiddle around on the screen, because... Or on the inventory menu. So figured why not. It'd be easier for you guys to see exactly what I'm doing, so you can judge me. But when you have the gamepad controller, you can just, like, switch items on the fly, you know? Oh, fuck, actually. Like, you don't have to pause the game in any capacity to switch items, which is, like, a first for Zelda. So I don't have to later. Which I know, it's like, oh my god, what? Crazy. Except for, like, Link Between Worlds, you can do that. And, I think in the DSL the games you can do it. But, that's just because, like, again, the niceties of having a second screen, I guess. I suppose. They use it well. Like, not as well as they could, but, like, this is a port of another game, so... I don't really expect this to be the game that uses the Wii U gamepad better than any other game. It's just kind of like a nice addendum, I guess. Is this a compass map? I don't think I have either yet. Compass. Hey! I love that. Link, don't worry about straying and meddling in the depths of the temple. Just relax and open your dungeon map, it'll show Medley's location as well, so you can easily confirm her whereabouts. Thanks, bruh. I do have the map. I'm the map. Ooh, fairies. Alright. My goal, as far as hearts in this game, is just to have more than 10, which I can... I can easily do now, because I have two more heart containers this way. Oh, Christ. Oof. I'm getting... These ghosts, I can't do anything about them. Right now. They go, like, in circles. He's freaking out. Man, I take a lot of damage. Sorry, we're gonna fuck these ghosts up. Yeah, you can't get me up here, ghosts. They probably could. They'll probably just, like, come up and murder me. Boom! I like having the 1,000 rupee wallet, but, like, as soon as it's full, it's like, ugh, there's all these rupees I've been getting. After this dungeon, I have to try and remember to, like, go and start doing some of the Triforce shard stuff. Because then I can, if I can get any charts, I can fucking spend this money. And not have to worry about going and getting more money later. Because, for those who don't know, I've mentioned before, like, the Triforce charts, you needed to get, like, 8 charts, before. And the charts, like, lead to Triforce shards, which you have to get 8 Triforce shards. But now, like, 5 of the charts... So you'd have to get the charts, go to Tingle, have them decoded, and it's 200, or it's like, actually it's like 300, maybe even more, it's 300 some odd rupees per chart to decode them. And that's a lot of money, one, not a big deal, right, because you get so many rupees in the final two dungeons, like you get a fuck ton. Like, I think I've already gotten, like, 200 rupees in here. But, it's a problem because, just, you can't get really access to all of those. You can't get... These re-deads in this game are fucking terrifying, by the way. You can't get access to all the charts until later on, because that's just how it works. You need, like, the hookshot, which you get in the next dungeon. Spoilers. And the mirror shield for some of them. I think the re-deads in this game are scarier than... Or less scary than the Ocarina of Time ones. But they're still really scary in, like, a different way. There are no re-deads in Twilight Princess, which is odd. I just realized that in my head, I think. There are Gibdos that still do, like, the scream and stuff, but they have swords. They don't latch onto you and start eating your brains. But anyway, the thing about, like, you pay all this money for Tingle, so you have 8 charts in the last game, which is, like, somewhere around... 3,000 rupees or something absurd like that. This guy. Super class. I like that this guy just comes an enemy in the next dungeon. So it's like an absurd amount of rupees just to begin with. So in this game, there are, instead of 8 charts that lead to the 8 shards, I think there are 5 places where you would get the charts that just give you the shards now. So there are only 3 charts. Which is nice. Bouncing around. Normally the heads will just start bouncing around, hopping every which way, trying to avoid your attacks. But anyway, my point is that I'm maxed out on rupees now, and it requires just more than 1,000 rupees to get all the all three Triforce charts decoded. So hopefully I can, like, decode at least one of them. And then refill my rupees in the next temple, and then I'll be set. Get the mirror shield. I love how the mirror shield looks in this game, I'll say. It looks like an evolution of, you know, the Hylian Shield. Same with Ocarina of Time. I'm not a big fan of how the Mirror Shield looks in Majora's Mask. Because, the only reason though is because I wanted it to look like the Hylian Shield, like it does in this game in Ocarina of Time. Like, the pattern is just really cool to reflect on. But the Mirror Shield in Majora's Mask fits with the motif, so it's not a big deal. Right. It's depressing looking. It's basically the point. Okay. I was like, oh god, this is gonna be embarrassing. I like it when you poke him in the butt. You're like, ah, my butt! I think we'll be okay for as far as getting stuff goes. Getting the Triforce shards. Or not Triforce charts. Triforce charts is what I'm trying to say here. Not really. We'll see. We'll see how it plays out. I'm not too worried. Up here. There. Nothing there. And then I'll call her. I'll just grab her. Just like she's like, I'm doing this for you, and you're like, get up! Throw her across the room.
Come on!
It is still tedious that you have to fucking still do it. Just like, oh. I still do have to do this. I still have to fucking play the song.
Yay, rupees.
Oh, it's just rupees. Great. They're going to so much use. After I put in all that work. Ugh. We're up here.
Yay!
You can see that cage there, that's where they cage up Medley. Alright. I do like the command melody at least. It's you know. It's a Jimmy Jam. Boom. That's a neat little thing. I like it. Alright, so we just need the big key. Chest in the room attack. We're gonna fuck these four masters up. I think it wants me to bring Medley around. Oops. There we go. It was a quick switch to error. The error. Nailed it. I like how you don't fall onto their emptiness. Just luckily. Alright, medley. Hang out here, grr. Grr. I'm trying to remember where the tingle chest in this dungeon is. Oh, we'll figure it out next time on Alex Plays Zelda. And when we do, maybe we'll beat this dungeon. I think we're about halfway through, so let's just like look at Link's. Link's just like, have you ever danced with the devil in the pale moonlight?